de brababa, mantene basta braca basta brababa, mantene basta braba basta brababa, mantene besta braca baba, ya braca busta brababa. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, mantene be. Masta braka bosta braka ya dala bosta brababa ya bandere besta braka baba ste brababa ya bada baste brababa mandesta baba ste braka baba in Jesus name. Beloved, this is God's messenger, Apostle Richard Kweku Opiniba Paka, known as the international preacher. I don't preach sermons, I only deliver God's messages. I came to my office and the Lord just ministered unto me, and I would like us to pray this hour. You know, Bible says men ought to pray without ceasing. It's about time we got to spend time in prayer. You know, Jesus Christ, Bible said he spent time in prayer. Jesus spent time and hours in prayer. Do you know why? Because the supernatural controls the natural. Beloved, the word itself is a spirit. I want to give you some information so that we can able to enter into heavyweight prayer. Somebody say heavyweight prayer. Oh my God. I'm going to blow your mind with some prayer topics, because Bible says once upon the time, Peter went to Jesus and said, Master, teach us how to pray. So there's a way we have to pray against certain things. We have so many dynamics and types of prayer. So there are prayer when you want to pray against your enemies. There are things you have to do. And there are things that if you are praying for favor, there are things that you need to do. So you got to be taught how to pray. Are you getting what I'm saying? You need to be taught how to able to pray certain prayer, use some weapons. You know, we have some weapons God has given unto us. One of them is the name of Jesus Christ. Bible says, by the mention of the name Yeshua, Bible says, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Are you getting what I'm saying? And the Bible says, I have given you power. Somebody say power. Oh my God. Someone say power, power, power. God has given you and I power over the powers of the enemy. I get to what I'm saying. So beloved, I want you to join the man of prayer. The man of prayer right now. We are about to enter to prayer and deal with certain things that the enemy is using to battle our life in the mighty name of Jesus. First of all, wherever you are, I just want you to pray that God, may God strengthen you. We need God to strengthen us. When Jesus was about to go to the cross, Bible says he went to Mount Gethsemane, and he prayed, and the Bible says an angel of God came down to strengthen him. Wherever you are, pray that God strengthen me in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, strengthen us in the name of Jesus. We need divine strength and empower us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. We need to be strengthened by the power of God. Ladies and gentlemen, pray, Master Pa, Rapata Papa, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the strength of Almighty God fall upon our life, and may God anoint our head with oil in Jesus' name. Name. Somebody say amen. Oh, hallelujah. The next prayer topic, my God, Bible says, man's enemy. Oh, my God. Man's enemy shall be the people of his own house. Your enemies is not far from you. Don't get it twisted. Bible said, man's enemy shall be the people of his own house. There are particular spirits and demons and people in our family. What they do is that they don't want you to go far. They don't want you to be blessed. We are praying by the supernatural power. Let fire crush them in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray, Madapa, Madapa, Madapa. We command fire to strike in the mighty name of Jesus. Brother, pray with me to the afternoon. Brother, sister, pray with me in the mighty name of Jesus. Let fire strike, oh God. Let fire strike, oh God. Let fire strike every enemies in our family. We crush them in Jesus' name. Amen. Third prayer. We are praying against fishing killers. Sister, there are people assigned in our life to make sure that our visions and our dreams and our purpose will never be met. It will never be achievable. Are you getting what I'm saying? Because Joseph told his brothers his dream, and they said that There comes the dreamer. Let us kill him so that we will see the outcome of his dream. Now, any conspiracy to destroy your life, any witchcraft to kill your marriage, to bring you down, people that have seen your greatness and they have seen your blessing and they have seen your favor and they have gathered together against you, beloved, let us pray that may thunder grab them, may fire grab them, may Holy Ghost thunder grab them. Shall we pray? Kappa, mandapa, 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 kappa, mandapa, fire, 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 fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, by the power of God, may the Lord deliver you. May the Lord deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But listen, just may pray. Rapata papa, madesta papa. We come against every forces, every enemies conspiring against our life. We bind in the name of Jesus. Brother, any conspiracy against you, ladies and gentlemen, any conspiracy, people that want to destroy your vision, are stopped by the power of God. I crush them in Jesus' name. Let fire interrupt their plan. Let Holy Ghost fire crush them in the name of Jesus. I am here and I prophesy. Your dreams and your vision and your purpose shall be accomplished. Oh, you didn't say amen. Let me tell you, your dreams, you know, Bible said, they try to stop the vision, the dream of Joseph. So they conspire. People that are conspiring against your life, let thunder crush them. Oh my God, you are not here with me. People, now listen to me. You have to know from the biblical point of view that we wrestle not against flesh and blood. Our weapons of warfare, the Bible said they are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of every stronghold. Ladies and gentlemen, any strongholds against your dream, strongholds against your miracle, strongholds against your favor, shall we all pray this afternoon that we are pulling them down? We are pulling them down. Shall we pray? Katahata, lima kute makadika hata, lima asikari pahatuwehaya. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pull them down. We pull every stronghold down in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic strongholds, I pull them down in Jesus' name. Hey, I prophesy. Listen to me. I prophesy with my eyes open that visions shall surely come to pass. The dream shall surely come to pass. The Bible said, no divination against Judah shall prevail, and no sorcery against Israel shall stand. So let me tell you, irrespective of whatsoever they are doing, that particular vision, that particular greatness, that particular marriage, that particular job, you shall have it in the name of Jesus. Oh my God. Can I repeat again? Now, let me blow your mind with this. If God, anything God starts, he has already accomplished it. My God, did you hear that? Anything God has started or starts, he has already accomplished it. So the devil has no authority over what God has started. Hey, I prophesy with my eyes open and by the oracles and by the prophetic degrees upon my life, that whatever God has started in your life, nobody can stop it. Nobody can break it down. Nobody can destroy it in the name of Jesus. Now they have to sell Joseph. My God, your enemies can never handle you. Oh my God. I'm not blowing your mind this afternoon. I say your enemies, they can never handle you. Do you know why? Because what you carry is above them. Oh my God. I'm not blowing somebody's mind this afternoon. What you carry is above them. And nobody can destroy what God has made in the name of Jesus Christ. So I declare in the name of Jesus, let anything that God has started come to pass in Jesus' name. Now, in order for Joseph, now let me blow your mind. The prayer is turning to another dimension right now, but I'll come back for prayer. Don't worry. In order for Joseph, vision and dreams to come to pass, ladies and gentlemen, you just hello. Yeah, I'm at the office. Yeah, so you can come. Okay. Rapata papa, madesta papa, ripatosta papa, rapata papa stepa, madesta papa, in the mighty name of Jesus. In order for Joseph vision to come to pass, Ladies and gentlemen, you can call my number if you need some prayer. If you need some prophetic declaration, you can call my number, 416-509-2833. 416-509-2833. Let me tell you something. In order for Joseph, my God, dream has to come to pass, he needs to be sold. The enemy have to sell him. And number two, my God, they have to lie against his, against him. Now, anything that is going on, it is going to end well by the prophetic power. Oh, you are not here. Anything that is going on against you, it is going to end well in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say, I hear you, man of God. A professor, it is going to end well. Now, another prayer topic that I want us to pray. Oh, my God. Another prayer topic. Bible says in the book of 2 Samuel 50, verse 31. When David heard that Ahithophel is among the conspirators, Bible said, David has to leave his house, leave his comfort zone, leave food, leave his bed, and leave his wives, and leave his children. Ladies and gentlemen, life is about war. It get to a time you must leave some people and enter into prayer. You must leave certain things and even leave some jobs and begin to pray. Because when heavens come to your aid, the earth shall respond to every cause of your need. Can I repeat again? When heavens come to your aid, the earth shall respond to the call of all your needs. Are you getting this prophetic statement? So David had to leave and went to mountains and said, oh God, turn the counsel of Ahithophel into foolishness. Ladies and gentlemen, there are people in our life that we talk to them, but they have not become enemies. They have become vampires and Al-Qaeda's, and they have become Talibans against our destiny. But we are here by the supernatural power. Shall we all pray? Let your counsel turn to foolishness. Let your counsel be interrupted. Let their counsel be broken in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Wherever you are, begin to pray with me in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Madapa, we turn it. I turn it to foolishness in the mighty name of the Lord. Any conspiracy of the enemy manipulating your life, by the authority given unto me as a messenger of God, I turn it into foolishness in the mighty name of the Lord. I turn it into foolishness in the mighty name of Jesus. I tell it by the power of God. Let it be turned. Let it be turned. Let it be turned. Let it be turned in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. I turn it to foolishness in Jesus' name. Brother, you can call me. I want to speak to your life. I want to speak to your life because I've been mandated by Elohim to release a prophetic word. You can call my number 416-509-2833. If you need some prophetic declaration, Bible said, for we shall decree a thing and shall be established. You don't need any prophet to tell you that you are going to be blessed. You need to speak a word over your life. And I stand by the authority. I speak over your life that nobody can bring you down. I interrupt the plans of the devil. Any plans of Ahithophel, against your life, I interrupt it. My God, you're not here with me. I interrupt by the supernatural power. Now, let me tell you what happened. After the prayer of David, something happened. Do you know that the prayer of David turned a spirit of suicide and visited Ahithophel? From today, let the spirit of God, my God, let the anger of God visit the camp of your enemies. Visit those who have sat down and they are talking bad about you. Thunder of God will visit them. Oh, you are not here with me. I said, thunder of God will visit them wherever they are in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So Ahithophel must go and hide himself. Brother, we have come to a technological realm, a state. So you do not use weapon. So you have to use prayer. I speak into the realms that anywhere they have conspired to bring you down, let the thunder of God interrupt it. Let thunder fight and break them in the name of Jesus. Someone say amen. Oh my God. Oh my God. I feel it. My God. We are going to pray that let it turn to favor us. Now their weapons has been turned into foolishness. Any voice against you, any statement against you, I turn it into foolishness. I don't know what you are going through, but any statement that you have made in order for you to be character assassinate or be prosecuted, listen to me. I speak by the authority and by the efficacy power of the blood that let it turn into foolishness. I place an embargo unto it that it shall never stand. May God divide and may God scatter every gathering of your enemy. May that be scattered in the name of Jesus. But we say, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Today I prophesy that your enemies are scattered in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Somebody say, I hear you, man of God. Beloved, we need to war. It's about time we got a war, because if we're not warring, you can never have a victory. Because if you like it or not, you are at war. So you must war. Can somebody write it for me? If you like it or not, we are at war. So you have to war. Are you getting what I'm saying? Because there are people aside that you can never move forward. I want us to pray against people aside. People that have been assigned against your progress, assigned against your ministry, your marriage that you are married, there are people assigned that they should make sure they say confusion. So don't joke with your prayer life. I am telling the job that you are doing, there are people there who have been employed by the devil to make sure that you lose your job. So let us pray against any assigned spirit, assigned human beings. Now, spirit operate through objects. So spirit uses object, any living thing or any object. So the first tool or instrument spirit use are human beings. So anybody that has been influenced by the enemy against your life, against your prosperity, against your favor, against your miracle, shall we pray to interrupt it? Shall we pray that let fire and this and crush them? Shall we pray kappa stepa le mata papa le 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 papa madapa madapa be madapa 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 be in the name of Jesus. My God, somebody say this and not stand. Oh my God, now, in order for you to overcome them, you got to be wise. You got to be wise. A lot of Bible says, Paul said that we are not ignorant of the devices of the devil. Huh? Brother, don't be ignorant when it comes to spiritual matters. Don't be ignorant. I want somebody to write this for me. Never be ignorant when it comes to physical spiritual matters. I am telling you, if you joke with physical spiritual matters, you will die before your time. I am telling you the gospel fact. If you are joking with spiritual matters, ladies and gentlemen, my God, that you are at a certain bad place. I am telling you, you must not joke with spiritual matters. Any spiritual issue going on, Bible says, so I went to sow a seed. He went to sleep, but it's at his enemy. Oh my God. There are people in our life, they are sowing bad things. Are you catching the revelation here? Oh my God. Are you catching the revelation? There are people in our lives. When you come on my page, you can share it so that others can be a blessing. There are people in our life, anything that we plant, they come and plant different things. Anything that you say, they twist it. Anything that you plant, they also plant something around it. We are going to pray right now. The people that come at work at midnight and sow and plant evil things against your life. People that are planning evil things against your destiny. People that when you are sleeping, they go and plant and sow some discord. Plant other seed in your life, your relationship. Today, my God, the power of prayer is here. I want you to release the power of prayer to crush them now in the mighty name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Pa, la, 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 in Jesus' name, none of their plans shall succeed. Brother, if we are keeping prayer alive, they will never have any chance to operate. I cover you with the blood of Jesus and I pray for divine security and heavenly protection, angelic divine protection, that wherever you go, there will be divine protection of Yahweh around your life in Jesus' name. Let me tell you that God has assigned his angels 24 hours a day to make sure that none of their arrows and none of their divination and their sorcery and their tongue against you shall never succeed. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that anything assigned to destroy you, Satan to lift you, Satan to lift you, Satan to lift you, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, it shall be done to lift you by the supernatural power and by the supremacy declaration over your life, that it shall tend to favor you. Somebody says, shall tend to favor me. Oh my God, it shall tend to favor you, sister, in the mighty name of the Lord. The devil is a liar, brother. The devil is a liar in the name of Jesus. If the devil knew that crucified Jesus Christ would have brought us salvation, he wouldn't have done it. The Lord will hide the end result from your enemies. Oh my God, I said something right now. I said the Lord shall hide the end result from your enemies. Whatsoever they are doing, they will never know the end result. Do you know why? Because God wants to save your enemies. From today, I prophesy, let your enemies be put to shame. God will save them. Huh? I said God will put them to shame. In the book of, let me read, let me give you a scripture. Don't go, please. I want you to see it and have time with me, because I want to drive you into prayer realms. Somebody say, drive me, drive me. I want to drive you in the name of Jesus Christ into, with a speedy refinancing into the realms of the spirit, so that we can able to have a prayer activation. Somebody say, prayer activation. Let me give you a scripture. We are going to base on that scripture and to declare a word. We are going to base on the scripture, because let me tell you something. Jesus used the word to defeat the enemy. We cannot use prayer to overcome the devil, but we use the word of God. Oh my God, don't get this twisted. It is the word of God that you can use to overcome the enemy. Because the devil is afraid of the word. He's not afraid of personality. He's afraid of those who carry the word. Because the word itself is God. So anytime you have the word, you have God in you. So God in you, the hope of glory. Why are you afraid of the enemies? Why? Why are you afraid of them? Nobody can hurt your life. In the book of Luke chapter 10 verse 19, he said, I have given you power. Someone said, you that you are listening to me, God said, I should tell you, I the Lord has given you power. And the power is not to steal. It's power to destroy the works of the enemy. The power to quench any flaming fire of the devil. The power to mute the voices of the enemy. The power to buy and the power to lose. Are you getting what I'm saying? So what you need is your voice. You need to speak a word. And I decree by the power of God that none of their plans shall stand. Every witchcraft and divination, sorcery and powers of darkness working against you 24 hours a day, making sure that you shall fall. You will never fall, but none of their plans shall stand. He says, speak your word. It shall not stand. Take counsel together. It shall be broken into pieces, for God is with me. And then he said, and the Bible said, if God be for you, who can be against you, brother? Who can be against you? Who can be against you? Who can be against you? Who are thou, O mountains, before Zerubbabel? You shall be plain. I speak that your enemy's voice will be muted. The voice of your enemies will be muted, but the spirit of God, it shall be muted in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Brother, they shall be put to shame, saith the Lord. The Lord shall make sure that none of their predicament against you shall succeed. Someone shall hear you. None of their arrows shall prevail, because you are under a divine security. Oh my God, Bible says, mountains surround Jerusalem. So is the Lord surrounding his people. May God surround you. May God protect your family. May he protect your children. May he protect your family. May there be divine security protection of God over your life. Can I hear amen now? Can I hear amen? Oh my God, I feel it today. I feel it today, sister. I feel it. I feel it. We must enter into prayer, and we must all spend time with God. He who does spend time with God can stand before any other creature. If you can kneel before God, bow before God, you can stand against every spirit. Are you getting what I'm saying? I see the fire of God crashing any predicament against somebody. Oh, somebody who are listening to me, there is a healing power that is coming upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because Bible says, whatsoever we bind shall be bound. There is no distance in the realms of the spirit. I want to speak a word to you right now. Please let me read the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 41. I want to leave you here with this Isaiah. Oh my God. Hey, katastu kataya baba. There is another Isaiah chapter 41. Please listen to me. Isaiah chapter 41. My God is alive. Verse 10 to 13. Fear not, for I am with you. He said, fear not. Why are you afraid? He said, fear not, for I am with you. The God from the foundation of the world. Hey, the God that created the firmament and the element of the winds and everything. He said, fear not, for I am with you. Beloved, let me come to physical life. When you are walking and you have macho men and soldiers around you, you become bold. Am I right? But let me tell you, there's somebody who is powerful than the soldiers, powerful than the security apparatus. His name is Jehovah Yeshua. He said, I am with you, my God. Let them bring all the cases against you. Let them say everything they are saying and let them take you to the court. God said, I should tell you, I am with you, my God. And you know that God doesn't step in when it is in the power of man to do it. He will just take his time and allow your enemies to face all the arrows and face all the holes and dig all the holes and plot all what they could do. And at the last hour, the Lord shall put your enemies there. Any plans against your life, anything meant to destroy you, the same thing that they meant to destroy you, your enemies shall fall into it. My God, they shall fall into their own trap. Somebody shall I hear you, man of God. Shall I hear you? He said, fear not, for I am with you, brother. God is with you there, irrespective of the condition that you find yourself. Let me tell you, He is in control. The Lord is with you like a mighty warrior. He's fighting the battle. What you need is to move forward. Don't look at the Red Sea. Don't look at the Pharaoh. Don't look at the circumstances around you. But looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. God shall put them to wherever they have planned to destroy. The enemy shall fall there. He said, fear not, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. Don't be dismayed. Don't be discouraged. At times, it looks like everything is coming to an end. It looks like your marriage is coming to an end. It looks like your ministry is coming to an end, man of God. It looks like everybody is against you. He said, do not be dismayed. Don't change your confession when things are tough. Hold on to your faith, because faithful is He that has promised. Oh, my God. Can I hear amen right now? The one that has promised you, he's not a man to lie. He's not like that your boyfriend. He's not like that your girlfriend. He's not like your president. He's not like your pastor. He is not a man to lie. Bible said, let everybody be a liar, but let God only be truth. So he said, do not be dismayed, brother. Don't be dismayed. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Maybe you have been suffering from God, but don't be discouraged on God. Don't give up. Don't give up. God is about to do something. Don't give up, sister. I'm speaking to you, brother. I'm speaking to you. Don't give up. Maybe you have been fired. Don't give up, because miracle is about to happen. Let me tell you who qualifies for a miracle. When everything seems like it is over, that is why you call for a miracle. Oh my God. So only thing that you need is to call. Like the black man at the mirror said, Son of David, have mercy upon me, Son of David. Son of David, I cannot call my mom in this situation. I'm calling the one that can have mercy upon me. Because men have rejected me. My family have rejected me. They said that I have been cursed, but they don't want to listen to my voice. But let me call the one who is upstairs, who can come in my aid and deliver me. And the Bible said, Jesus said, somebody's calling me, call him for me. And the people that were silencing the man, the same people brought him, the man, to Jesus. This very stool, let me take my time to blow your mind here. The elements and the devices meant to destroy you, let me tell you prophetically, God is going to use the same thing
to promote you. The same people that are trying to sit down on you, God is going to use them as a stepping stone into your miracle. Oh my God. Can I receive some shout here? The same people are going to be used for your miracle. The same people, God is going to use them to elevate you. The same people, God is going to use them to blow your mind. Are you getting what I'm saying? Oh, hallelujah. He said, fear not, for I do not be dismayed. Let me continue. I will help you and I will uphold you with my righteousness. Huh? He said, I, the Lord, I am going to help you. Hey, 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 hey. Someone say, hey, hey. Someone say, hey, 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 hey. He said, fear not, for I will help you. Hey, this is a powerful word. Onyame said, na boaw. Let me speak to you here. He said, na boaw. He said, fear not, for I will help you. God shall help you. In all that day, David said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. Where comes my help? Where would my help come from? He said, my help will come from the supremacy. May God help you. Oh my God. As we are sharing this Facebook live message, the Lord will help you. I see a help coming. Oh my God, my God, my God. I see a help coming from the Lord. I see a help. Oh my God. Somebody share it for me. I see a help coming to you from the Lord. There is a help coming. Oh my God. Huh? They thought that you have ended your career, but God is bringing a help. And help is coming from above. They thought that they have finished with you, but there is a help coming. They thought that they have ended your vision, but there is a help coming. Somebody shout help, 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 help. I see your help coming in the mighty name of Jesus. I see your help coming. God will help you, sister. Brother, God will help you. You want to start a business. You want to start your own company. I said God is going to help you. My God, men will always try to refuse to help you. That is man. Don't worry about that. That is humanity. They will always turn their back when you need them. That is man. That's why Bible says, don't put your trust. Hallelujah. You can trust, but don't put in your trust. That's another explanation. Into man, but trust upon God. And they that trust God, they shall do exploits. Are you getting what I'm saying? So he said, do not be dismayed, for I will help you. Sister, you will go to that school you want to go. You become the doctor that you want to become. You become that professor. You become that first lady. You shall become that woman of God that God has destined you to be. I remember when God called me and said, you are going to be international preacher. So that my name is given to me from the Lord. And nobody can take it out of my life. And he said, I'll make you the voice of the city. Nobody can take it from me. He said, you will control prayer and distribute prayer. Nobody can take it from me. He said, I will give you message to deliver. So I don't preach sermon. Nobody can take it out from me because it is not given unto me by any man. It was given to me by the one that saw me. Oh my God, the one that created the heavens and the earth. He gave it to me. So nobody can take it from me. And let me tell you, whatsoever the Lord has given unto you, nobody can take it from you. My God, this is a prophetic word. Can somebody receive it for me? I want somebody to receive it before I continue. I want to hear, I receive it. I want somebody to receive it. No, I want to hear someone receive it before I continue. I said, listen to me. Anything that God has given to you, nobody can take it from you. Can I hear and receive it now? Anything that God has given to you, let them do whatever they do. Nobody can take it from you. I am telling you, anything God has given to you, the marriage, the blessing, the breakthrough, your children, nobody can destroy them. My God, I prophesy, sister, believe it. Faith, have faith and believe it. Nobody can take it from your life. Can I hear receive? Can I hear someone say, I receive it? Because it is a prophetic word. So that I can continue. Help me to continue. Just help me to continue. Okay, I can see some people are receiving. It shall be your portion. It shall be your portion. Oh my God, they can never take it out of your life. It is part in your DNA. Oh my God, and you are in Jesus. And Jesus is in God. So how can they destroy your life? He said, do not be dismayed. I'm reading for Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10 to 13. Behold, all those who were increase against you shall be ashamed and disgraced. Hey, someone say Jehovah. Hey, this is the word. My God, I'm touched. Can I repeat it again? Oh my God, my God. Can somebody help me to say thank you, Jesus? Can somebody help me? Let me repeat. Isaiah 41, verse 11. Behold, all those who increase against you shall be ashamed and disgraced. Hey, so it is data. A threat to your enemies when they try to come after you. If somebody wants to die early, let him come after you. If somebody wants to end his career, lose his job, go through frustration, and be denied of peace in his or her marriage, then let the person come and fight you, because it is written over your life that all those who increase, oh my God, my God, hey Jesus, Adumo, Adumbiwo Yesumo, Adumo, Adumbiwo Yesumo, Adum, 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 Obiara Wadum. You see, any people that increase against you, Bible said, they shall be put to shame. They shall be put to shame. That is the word of God. Beloved, I want you to have time with me, because something is happening. You need a word. You see, you need an accurate and prophetic, energetic word that will stir up your inner person so that you can able to move forward. Because without the spirit, nobody can do nothing. Life is all about spirit. I am telling you from today, everything that you see physically was once in the realms of the spirit. So you need the spiritual understanding in order to control things in the physical. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Share it for me, sister, brother. I love you. I love you for being with me. I love you so much. Now, he said, they that increase against you. So it means every day your enemies are increasing. Do you know why? It is because your blessings are multiplying. Hey! Someone say, man of God, talk to me. Someone say, messenger, talk to me. Someone say, Teresa preacher, talk to me. Someone say, the voice of Toronto, talk to me. Talk to me. I want somebody to write it. Talk to me, talk to me. The reason why your enemies will be increasing is that your blessing will continue to multiply. So it always also increase your enemies. So the result of a blessing can increase your enemies. But Bible said, in the presence, oh my God, I love to deliver. In the presence of all your enemies, I, the Lord, will set you table. He said, I, the Lord, in the presence of your enemies, I will prepare. Do you know why God is, do you know why you think that you are being delayed, or it is too slow, or things are not working faster? All your enemies are not gathered yet. It's a top secret. All your enemies have not yet gathered. Some have traveled. Some of them are yet to be exposed, because they are enemies that are within, but they are not yet exposed. So God wants to expose them, and in the presence, in the very presence of those who wish you dead, in the very presence of those who took you to Obia, who took to Juju, who took to deity for you to die, who accused you wrongly, in the same people, your elevation will be given to you, your breakthrough will be released to you, in the mighty name of Jesus. They shall witness it by the supernatural power. Oh my God, the brothers said that will not allow us to witness this dream of Joseph, but you know, in the very presence, they bow down. This year, your enemies are bowing down. They will bow down to you. This man, all your accusers are bowed. In Jesus' name, let me blow your mind with this word so that I continue. They refused to bow down to Joseph in Egypt, in Israel, right? Right? They refused to bow down to Joseph in Israel. But in Egypt, they could not deny. They could not refuse. The breakthrough of God is coming. Those that refused to years ago or yesterday, 2017, today onwards, they will never able to refuse you anymore, because your upliftment is coming by the supernatural power. They that deny you yesterday will beg for your acceptance today. They that thought that you are going to die, they will come and see how far the Lord has lifted you. Oh my God, my Jehovah, I see that business coming on. I see that business you want to start, that company. I see it being established as a voice of God. I see it, and I prophesy it now. Can somebody say, I take it, I take it? Can you write that? I take it. Say, I take it, I take it. Oh my God, it is for somebody. I see it now, my God, because my eyes has been opened into the spiritual activities, and I see that all the plans of your enemies has been put to shame, has been shattered by the blood of Jesus Christ, has been shattered down. Oh my God, brother, you have been lifted. Brother, you have been lifted. Sister, you have been lifted. I see God lifting somebody. Oh my God. There's someone listening to me right now. I see God lifting you. God is lifting you to the next level. I see it, and it shall come to pass. He's lifting you in the mighty name of Jesus. He said, all that increase against you shall be put to shame. Fear the Lord. Hey, you don't. You have. He said, all that increase They are increasing because your blessings are continuing to multiply. They are increasing in numbers of your enemies because God will continue to bless you. But all of them shall be put to shame in the name of Jesus Christ, my God. And the Bible says they shall be disgraced. Oh, this is two weapons. Say, a fire. My enemy will shame and disgrace. Say, bagam, 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 fire, fire, bagam, 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 bagam. Fire your enemies with shame and disgrace. May God fire your enemies with the word shame and the word disgrace. Oh, beloved, are you with me? This is a charisma preacher, a man that doesn't preach sermons but only deliver message. I said, may God fire your enemies with the word shame and disgrace. In the name of Jesus, they shall be put to shame. In the name of the Lord, my God. Someone say, I take it, I take it, I take it, I take it. Say, it is my portion. It is going to be your portion. In the name of Jesus. Can I continue, please? I am doing it with you, my viewers. I love you so much. Can I continue? Can somebody write continue? Somebody write continue. Because I want to flow with you. My God. Number two. He said, they shall be as nothing, and those who strive with you shall perish. Hey, Bible said, they shall be as nothing. So don't be afraid. Those who are striking with you, they shall perish. In the mighty name of Jesus. And the Bible says, you will seek for them, and you will never find them no more. In the name of Jesus. They that contend with you shall fall. 2017, they that will contend against you, sister, they will fall into their own trap. I am telling you the gospel fact, and the word of God can never be broken. He said, they that are seeking your downfall, they shall fall before you in the mighty name of Jesus. Do you know that the lions could not do nothing against Daniel? Do you know why? Let me blow your mind. You see, God will step in when all your enemies wanted your downfall. God is going to step in, and those who plotted that evil, they shall fall into their own trap in the name of Jesus. God sent us a professor. Someone say, professor, prophecy means declaring a word and it must come to pass. That is a prophetic word. And let me tell you, I have graduated from I see to I declare. I declare over your life in the name of Jesus. As we have spent time with the messenger of God, let every accusation, let any elements, let any forces, let any darkness and powers of the enemy who have gathered against your success be broken into pieces by the authority in the name of Jesus. Let fire disengage their plans. Let thunder bagagagagaga. Let thunder interrupt their plans in Jesus' name. Anywhere they have taken your picture, anywhere they have taken your picture, anywhere they are taking your picture, let fire visit them. Anywhere they are taking your clothes, anybody enchanting against you on Obia, in Obia, taking your picture, enchanting that you die. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Rapata papa. Let fire, let fire, let fire crash in the name of Jesus. Somebody pray. Kada, kada. Hello. Yes, Lord. I am in prayer, so it is well with you, okay? Go with the favor of God, for the case has been set by Elohim. Go with the favor. Amen. Kaba, lara, 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 lara. I speak it in the name of Jesus. Now my last declaration. Hey, I see upliftment coming. God said, I should release prophetic upliftment. I don't know where you are. Mephibosheth was at Lodiba. He was forsaken and was rejected. But there was a day of divine acceptance and divine remembrance that fall upon Ahithophel, and he moved from Lodiba, a place of no communication, to a king's palace. From today, I declare, anywhere they have placed you, so that you can never move forward, so that you can never get married, so that you can never have any breakthrough, I see the power of God, I declare. Let the power of God catapult you. Somebody write catapult. Let the power of God. I want somebody to write catapult. If you write it, miracle will happen to you. I am in the third realm, so I am telling you, brother, I'm not here to entice you. I'm here to speak the unadulterated and to energize your inner man to able to pray. Are you getting what I'm saying? I said, write catapult, please, and you begin to see a miracle in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, let that God take you from Lodiba to the king's palace and shower his favor upon your life. May God shower his breakthrough over your life. May God lift you, brother. May God cause you to have long life in the name of Jesus. And may you see the end of the result of your enemies. And may a table be prepared in the presence of your enemies. And let your cup run over. And may you dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. In Jesus' name. Ladies and gentlemen, this is God bless you, Princess Frederica. Princess Frederica, God richly bless you for being obedient. God bless you, Mama, the First Lady. God richly bless you, Sinead. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh my God, God bless. Let me acknowledge those who have just joined me. Oh my God, God bless you so much. Beloved, I have a message entitled, Be Careful of What You Hear. This message is one of the top messages, my God, trending all over social media. And a lot of people are calling for the CD. My God, the gospel is not for sale. It's for free. If you need it, please call my number, 416-509-2833. I will ship it to you for free. You need to hear this message. Be careful of what you hear. Because what you hear form part of your thinking faculty. And it can develop a character. It's for free. I don't sell the gospel. The gospel is for free. So if you need it, contact the international man, God's messenger. The man that doesn't preach sermon but only deliver message. And I have another one. You can't be cursed. All this is YouTube. You can search it. You can't be cursed. Hey! Nobody can place a curse on you because you are from the seed of Abraham. You are blessed. So you need all this CD. Contact me. You'll be given the name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, tonight, I have one of the top powerful prayer line. We are going to be on a prayer line. It's going to be massive. If you want to pray, prayer, you see, we have dynamics of prayer. We don't just pray because the daughters of Zelophehad, Bible said they went and appealed their case before Moses, before God, and before Moses. And Moses took it to God. And their request was granted. There's a way you have to pray. There's a way we pray against enemies. There's a way we pray for favor. There's a way we lose and bind and we catapult and we wire and we disconnect and we connect and program and deprogram and adjust and adjust. So if you want to pray that kind of prayer, tonight I'm respectfully inviting you from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The number to call is 1-877-111-465. Join this hottest prayer conference and your life will be transformed. Thousands of people are on this prayer line praying. And God is blessing people. I'm telling you, blessings of God is falling upon people. Today, a lot of people have called and they have received miracles. I don't show testimonies on my Facebook page. I had people's reputation. I don't bring up, but God is really touching life. And this coming Friday is going to be hot. We are starting our Easter convention. My God, the price has been paid. Toronto, if you need a church that believes in Jesus, where the true gospel is being preached, unadulterated, infallible message, my God, come to Red Bay Chapel International, and Jesus will turn your life around. Every Saturday, Friday is 8:30 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. And Saturday is going to be 7:30 to 10 p.m. And Sunday is going to be the resurrection day. Hey! The jubilant day. So I would like you to come and you'll be blessed in the name of Jesus. You can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, wherever you can search. You can follow me and I will lead you to the path of Jesus. I will lead you to the path of Jesus. God will richly bless you in the name of the Lord for spending time with me, for us to have a power prayer moment. I'll come on your way maybe in the evening or tomorrow because God has spoken to me to bring revival of prayer there, back to prayer days where people pray. I remember I climbed mountains 14 hours. Come on. 14 hours. Some people pray the whole day. Mama, prayer is a medicine. I want to encourage you to pray. Prayer is a medicine. And prayer is a force that drives away spirit of darkness. When you pray more, disease can never enter into your body. You become energetic and empowered by the grace of Elohim. I have spoken unto your life, and so shall it be. Once again, God bless you for taking your time to listen to international preacher, messenger of God, Apostle Richard Kweku Biriba Paka, the founder and general overseer of Red Bay Chapel International. God will richly bless you. I love you. I love you so much. I respect you. And may God bless you for spending time investing time with me to listen to this Facebook Live prayer. Let us pray. God, we bless you. I love you so much. In Jesus' name, special greetings to all my church members. I love you so much. All the senior men of God. Hey, the spirit man. The spirit man. God, we bless you. The spirit man. Ha. This is your name. I have to sow a seed to the name. The spirit man. God bless you. JC Ola Tolipo. Hey, Ola Depot. God bless you for joining us, all the people. God with you, bless you. Princess, God bless you. So, oh, Prophet Emmanuel Tre, God bless you. Razak, God bless you. Oh, God bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Na Ashida, God bless you. God bless you for joining me tonight. I'm done for the day. I love you. If you want to call me, 416-509-2833. I'm very, very humble to receive your call and to pray with you. 416-509-2833. I love you. God bless you. I love you. I'm missing you already. I don't want to leave you, but I leave you with Jesus Christ, that he is the one that you have to give your life. He is the one that you have to surrender your life. He loves you. He will never disappoint you. So if you don't know Jesus, I want to use this platform to tell you about Jesus, that give your life to him. He will bless you, open doors for you. Jesus is love. He is love. He is love. Give your life to him and you have eternal life. Because if you have everything and loses your life, then it's all vanity. So I love you, and I'm introducing Jesus, who has made my life the way I am, who has made me the voice of this city. God richly bless you. And next time I'll come your way in Jesus' name. I love you all. Kinsley Bright Asari, God richly bless you, man of God, senior man of God, for joining us. I love you so much. I'm coming to Kofobia very soon to bring the, you know, the vibrator, you know, spirit of prayer, the night, the sweet prayer, in the name of Jesus Christ. I love everybody who have spent time to join me. I love you. God bless you all. Bye. Tonight I'll be on my prayer line. Bye. Bye. I don't know how to leave you. Wow. What a awesome presence that has just fed on us. You have a testimony. I'm telling you, there's a testimony coming. There is a testimony. Man of God, there's a testimony. Man of God, there is a testimony. There is a testimony. I have seen it and it shall come to pass. I love you. God bless you. Bye.